Firstcry brings smiles. How Firstcry makes customers smile. Consider these three items: a hammer, a toy, and a fork. Now, which one of these will you give to a baby? A toy, right? Yes, of course, since a hammer or a fork can harm a baby. Also, while choosing a toy, we need to avoid the ones with sharp edges or poor quality materials, since they can be really dangerous. So when it comes to buying toys for their newborn baby, the parents can be very paranoid. Now, how did Firstcry address their concerns? Let's find that out in this video. Supam Maheshwari was a first-time dad of a lovely baby, and he wanted to buy the best things for his child. But there was a problem. Whenever Supam went to the supermarket, he found it very difficult to find a good toy for his child. Why? Because he hardly knew any brand that would produce good quality and risk-free toys for toddlers. Confused at times, he would end up buying low-quality products. As a result, he couldn't let his child play with these toys unsupervised. Now, Supam was not the only one with these concerns. He realized that every parent of a newborn baby had similar worries. Now, the parents did not mind paying a premium for safe and quality toys, but finding such products was difficult. All they wanted was to have all the options of the baby products at one single place, since it would help them browse, compare, and make an informed decision. So, after some research, Supam saw these jaw-dropping statistics. He estimated that there would be about 25 million parents like him in India alone, which meant that the aggregate demand for toys was estimated to be about 7,500 crore Indian rupees. So, two things were very clear. The demand was genuine and the demand was huge. Now, after gaining this information, an idea struck Supam. And as a result, he launched Firstcry in 2010. Firstcry became the first digital platform connecting parents with quality baby care brands. It was a huge success among the first-time tech-savvy parents who wanted the best on the click of a button. Now, Firstcry also realized that there was a huge market for parents who enjoyed spending quality time with children shopping. And this led Firstcry to its second big opportunity. In 2011, Firstcry launched its retail stores in Bangalore, Kolkata, Pune, and Delhi. And in time, it grew from 4 to 400 plus stores across India. Now, after starting retail stores in various parts of the country, Supam observed that the majority of his demand was coming from small towns. Hence, Supam quickly realized that these towns were his bigger market. So, Firstcry started delivering toys through its own delivery service called Express Bees. And voila! This became the third big opportunity for Firstcry. Supam realized that besides transporting toys from Firstcry, Express Bees can transport many more goods for other companies too. Hence, Express Bees started a logistics company delivering all goods. And as of 2019, it delivers 60 lakh shipments in just one day. Soon, Firstcry realized that parents are not just concerned about choosing the right products, but they're also anxious about parenthood. Thus, again, Firstcry was able to convert this into the next opportunity. Firstcry created an open platform where parents could read articles about parenting, ask questions to fellow parents, and discuss their ideas. Firstcry could get all these opportunities only because they were so close to their customers, which is parents. Owning to all these, Firstcry became a favorite online platform for most Indian parents. Now, just like every business, Firstcry too faced challenges. and one of them was its competitor, Baby Oi, backed by a giant corporate house, the Mahindra Group of Companies. But Firstcry even converted this challenge into an opportunity and acquired Baby Oi from Mahindra Group. This acquisition changed the fortunes of Firstcry. Firstcry grew from India's largest mother care and baby platform to Asia's largest online platform for babies and kids. So, what did we learn from Firstcry? The first and foremost thing is that we should always stay close to the customers. And secondly, we should keep identifying their problems. And then we should build solutions that resolve their concerns. In short, making the customer smile is the only way you can succeed in your venture. And Supam just did that. So, did you find the journey of Firstcry interesting? Do let us know your thoughts in the comments section below. And don't forget to visit the Empower website to learn more about entrepreneurship. Happy learning!